everybody, 1 minute. Lift up your 2 hands, give him all the glory. Let your voice be louder than the voice of your neighbor. Believe me, you won't go back the way you came. Believe me, you won't go back the way you came. Believe me, you won't go back the way you came. Let your voice be louder than the voice of your neighbor. Lembrado sotolis, embrodo sotoligeres, lembrado sotoligara, mangrevo sotolige, legredo sotolis, lembradasos, yecredo sotoligeres, embrodo sotoligara. Everything will change. Everything is changing. Everything will change. Let your voice be louder than the voice of your neighbor. Let your voice be louder than the voice of your neighbor. Egrebo sotoligaras, embredo siash. I'm giving everybody 1 more minute. There is a shift in the atmosphere. 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 Embrades, embradosis, lembradosiade, mangrebo sotoligere, lepredo sotoligara, menrebo sotoligara. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. In Jesus' precious name. I am thinking somebody's amen will be the loudest. I am still thinking somebody's amen will be the loudest. Finally, the change you have been waiting for is finally here. Somebody saying the loudest amen, in 24 hours there shall be a change of story. I am operating absolutely from my apostolic office. Please listen very carefully. For I carry an apostolic oil, and I am here to execute an apostolic mandate, because this is a generational visitation. That blessings you are looking for, we start looking for you from tonight. I speak to you in the name that is above every other name. Hear me carefully. That delay is over. That disappointment is over. That denial is over. I command that bleeding to stop right now. Check it. I don't know who you are. There is a woman here. Fibroid has just disappeared from your body. There is a young boy of 8 years developing glaucoma. Instantly now, check it. You are healed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everyone with any form of respiratory disorder, breathe in and breathe out. Stubborn cough, inability to breathe properly, all kinds of respiratory disorder. Right now, breathe in and breathe out. You are healed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say to you by the Spirit of Christ, everyone under the sound of my voice globally, within the next 48 hours, I speak as a prophet, every money you are expecting shall be paid. I hear clearly, 48 hours of payments. Whatever payment you are expecting, I don't know from the quarters, in that name that is above every name, beginning from tonight there shall be payment. I hear clearly from this hour your payment will no longer be delayed. Your blessings will no longer be delayed. Your progress will no longer be delayed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That lady in red clothes, just they should just say, yeah, no. Yes. The one that you have some, yes, just step forward. Not her. No, the one before. Yes. Everybody stretch forth your two hands. Lebra ando siadi. There is an angel to my right talking to me. There are lists and there are names. Why I will go into the word of the Lord, I will move into some dimensions of operation. There is a door you have been knocking. There is a door you have been knocking. It's a massive expectation. There is a door you have been knocking. You have prayed about it. You have done whatever you need to do about it. There is a massive delay concerning it. Right now, see the Spirit of the Lord, the delay is over. The delay is over. By the power that raised Christ from the dead, I use her as a point of contact. Hear the word of the Lord. Your expectations shall no longer be delayed. You have long been waiting at that door, knocking it. Just hear the Spirit of the Lord again. That delay is over. Say it, the Spirit of the Lord. Lift up your two hands, everyone. Embra andebo soto libra caste. Angels are moving all over this auditorium. Angels are moving and they are distributing gifts. At this point, forget about your neighbor. Do as if you are the only one here. Angels are moving all over this auditorium. The spirit of just men is here. The spirit of just men is here. The spirit of Benson in the house, the spirit of David Oyedepo, the spirit of Kenneth Hagin, the spirit of just men is overrunning all over this atmosphere. Generational ancestral problems are being solved. Generational ancestral problems are being solved. Curses are being broken. Shame is being converted to glory. Disgrace is being turned to grace. Prakasia dekere endebo sotoli garas. In Jesus' precious name, I'm seeing clearly a screen playing in front of me. Ambro endia satolia garadash leprodosia di indobo sotoli garaste leprokese. A prominent family in this church, 16th of August this year, they are supposed to be coming from a journey from around Benin. I can see clearly the picture. And as they pass Ijebode, advancing towards Shagamu, a massive accident claiming the life of the two, a man and his wife, making the whole church to mourn. Immediately, it has been shown to me, and I hear clearly it has been averted. I hear him as a man here, his friend. Everybody hear this. Death by accident is averted here. Everyone saying amen right now. Surely you won't be involved in an accident. Hear this before I go into the word of the Lord. The arrow of accident is back to sender. The arrow of accident is back to sender. 1 minute, lift up your two hands and give him thanks. Lebro endebo setes. Embro and ashes. Leprondo seteli brades. Lembrado sotoli garesh. Endro siades. Preketutis. Embracotis. Hey, I know this as I know my name. There is a shift. We give you praise. In Jesus' precious name. I am thinking your amen will still be the loudest. Somebody scream with me, my time has finally come. Join me quickly tonight. Celebrate God's general, Pastor Olumide Emmanuel, and the First Lady. Is this how to celebrate grace? Is this how to celebrate grace? And let's say to him, happy birthday in advance, sir. Say it louder and louder. Say it louder and louder. Okay, say it for the last time. We celebrate you, sir. We love you, sir. Happy birthday in advance. Calvary, we can do better to celebrate God's general. We give him praise. What will I say about my senior brother, Pastor Shegu Abraham, a faithful and loyal assistant, and the entire leadership team of Calvary? Join me, celebrate the entire leadership team of Calvary, all the pastors. Oh my God. Look at your, okay, look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, I celebrate you. Put your hands together and be seated. Our God is good. And all the time, I bring you greetings from the Master's Place International Church, Worry Where We Don't Worry. I live in Worry Where God Lives. Hallelujah. Is somebody still there? Your life will never remain the same again. Hallelujah. I came with a team tonight, all the way from Asaba. Pastor Kennedy, join me, celebrate him. And all the way from Lagos here, Entrainment Assembly, Pastor Leji came with me, join me, celebrate him. And a host of my other sons. It's such a prophetic night. Quickly, operating kingdom economy. Yeah, and this is a broken tear. The word that I speak to you, they are spirit and they are life. So as I'm speaking the word now, thank God for that first word. You can't despise the process and have the product. You can't. Many love the promise, but despise the process. And it's the reason why many are on the floor. Somebody scream with me, I love the process. Well, I'm thinking you will scream it authoritatively. Now, we are in a kingdom that operates by principles. You know it is written, his ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. And the truth is this, whatever is from above is above all. So therefore, the principles of the kingdom, they are over and above the principles that operate in this world. Because whatever is from above is above all. There is an economy that operates in this kingdom. Hear this. No one can provide like God. There is no president on earth. There is no king that can stand up and look at all the citizens of the nation and announce to them, come to me, all ye. There is no nation that the president called the nation America, called the nation China. There is no nation that the leadership of the nation can come out and declare, in this nation, come to me, all ye that are poor, and we shall give thee rest, and we shall make ye rich. There is no such nation, but there is a God with oceanic blessing
The more you remove from the ocean, the more the ocean doesn't know. It's called the El Shaddai, the full-breasted one. Ebabasia brakatia dakaras. Exodus chapter 16, verse 4. Look at Exodus chapter 16, verse 4, quickly with me. La bruandia sia brakatia dakaras. No one can provide like God. He said, tell the children of Israel, they must gather every day. Somebody shout with me, they must gather every day. Then said the Lord unto Moses, behold, I will rain bread from heaven for you in the wilderness, and the people shall go out and gather a certain rate every day. Even in the wilderness, no kitchen, no farming, no market, no buying, no sales. Then this El Shaddai, Hebrew 13:8, the same yesterday, today, and forever. He said, I will rain down bread from heaven, and you shall gather daily. And he did it for 40 years. Do you know who you are serving? Lack is a choice. In kingdom economy, you are not drawing from the resources of where you are. There was nothing for them to draw from naturally in the wilderness. But there is a source they were connected to. You draw from your source, not from a channel. The work of your hand, thank God for it, is a channel. You need to distinguish. Mama Siabra. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 4. Look at what God said to them. Look at what God said to them. I love this. Look at what God said. Thy raiment works not hold upon thee, neither did thy foot swell these 40 years. Exodus 16, 4, he said, in this wilderness, you won't be able to plant. No commerce. I will rain down bread for you. No textile industry. Nowhere to make clothes. And he now said to them, in Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 4, thy raiment works not hold. Do you know the meaning of that? You give birth to a child, suddenly clothes will appear on the body of the child. As the child is growing, without washing the clothes is growing and changing color, and yet not losing color. You don't know the one you serve. If he can provide in the wilderness, he can provide much more outside of the wilderness. Because naturally speaking, it should have been more difficult for him to provide in the wilderness than outside of the wilderness. If he met their need in the wilderness, how much more will he meet your need that are now living outside of the wilderness? And when you are even in the metamorphorical stages of life and you are in the wilderness, it is when then he is ready to manifest. Mama si brakatia dish. We operate an economy that no force, no power. The truth is, my personal income increased over 4,000% during lockdown. Our church income grew over 1,000% during lockdown, sir. If what is affecting others naturally affects you, you don't understand kingdom economy. So follow me as I take you on this apostolic journey out of lack. And I'm talking about supernatural provisions. Proverbs 10:22, the blessing of the Lord makes rich and has no sorrow. I mean resources that is from heaven. So follow me as I carry out an endoscotomy of scriptures to help you, because it is true. Money is not everything, but poverty is nothing. A poor believer is a minus. Listen to me. Poverty will affect you more than Satan will affect you. The truth is this. Poverty is the real devil. All the other devils are dead. You don't know? Lack? A poor Christian is a minus. It's a minus. I say authoritatively over somebody, now enter into the reality of kingdom economy. It will be from glory to glory. You will be basking in supernatural provisions. I say to you, lack and want has come to an end in your life. This economy is superior. I mean, kingdom economy is superior to the economy of the world. Right in the midst of the lockdown, we moved to 6 services from 4 services. Right in the midst of the lockdown, our multi-billion naira project continued non-stop, sir. Resources flying in from everywhere. Baba si habroko shiada. It's time to take over the market. With all humility, I carry a financial grace. And beginning from tonight, your agreement with lack shall not stand. Your agreement with poverty shall not stand. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everybody lift up your right hand and scream with me, kingdom economy. Kingdom economy. Well, I'm thinking you will scream it authoritatively. Louder, louder. For the last time, higher and higher. Quickly, 2 Corinthians chapter 8 verse 9. He paid the price for you to be rich. You know the grace of our Lord Jesus, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that you through his poverty might be made rich. For I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospers. Labro and their shia adisalia brakas. Lia akito prikatash. A poor Christian is a minus. Listen to me. It's a minus. And let me quickly establish this. Anyone God will bless must know why God blesses. Why? Look, it doesn't take God anything to make all of us here a billionaire. Any Christian that failed the money test can never be blessed by God. Therefore, listen, more than your labor, more than your diligence, more than your planning, more than your business skills, the scheme of things in the kingdom is that by strength shall no man prevail. God won't allow a Christian to be blessed more than he, God, has blessed that Christian. Never. So, believers that want to prosper, using the style of unbelievers, it's not going to work. There is nowhere God can't get resources across to you. I mean, there is nowhere. I don't know, bro. I am never broke. I receive every day. God give me money. Satan give me money. From everywhere, you must drop it. I am a magnet. The blessing of the Lord, he maketh rich and hath no sorrow. When a man's way pleases the Lord, he maketh even his enemies to be at peace. Look at your neighbor and touch your neighbor. Say, neighbor, I don't like poverty. Look at another neighbor and say, new neighbor, I hate poverty. Turn to another neighbor and say, my newest neighbor, I hate lack. Okay, let me test you. If you Love lack. Let me see your hand. Don't pretend. No pretense here. No pretense here. Not even Satan can compete with God. Satan can't compete with God. But the Bible says you can't serve God and money. So what Satan does is to now hide behind money to afflict Christians. That is why it is entrustment. God can't give you more than he can trust you. Whatever God will give you that he will lose you, he can't give you. It's entrustment. You don't know that some of you angels come to you. If you have 1 billion naira now, what will you do? You first laugh. I beg, now wrong woman I marry. I go change woman. If I have 1 billion now, no, I go marry you. If I go Dubai first. God will call angel that. You say you are listening to him. Ask him more. If you have 1 billion naira now, what are you going to do? Me? I will first travel to US for 3 months to think and just be in an hotel. Look at me. In the Bible, there is no one God bless without testing their capacity to handle the blessing. Money has capacity to be worshipped. You must break the power of money over your life because it is for spiritual. Money is for, please listen. Any rich man you know, read the story of Bill Gates, you are just deceiving yourself. Read Dangote, quote all of them. Any billionaire, you read about their story without knowing their spiritual life, you don't know anything about them. There is no one that has billions without spiritual connection, either to God or to Satan. And when you connect to Satan, you know, Satan said to Jesus, bow and I will give you. So worship and wealth goes together. Satan said to Jesus, if you worship me, I will give you. So in worship, there is exchange. There is an exchange. How can you be worshiping the Almighty and you are broke? How can you be worshiping the Almighty and you have nothing? Somebody lift up your right hand quickly. I'm going somewhere this evening. Shout with me in the mighty name of Jesus. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, I break the power of lack over my life. Why will God bless a Christian? Let me say it again. It doesn't cost God anything to make all of us here billionaires. It doesn't cost God anything. But are you really ready? Let's take these two scriptures quickly. I see generational billionaires rising up from here. The Gospel of Mark, chapter 13, verse 10. Ambra Sotolosh. The Gospel of Mark, chapter 13, verse 10. And the gospel must first be preached among all nations. You can give me New King James. And the gospel must first be preached. The gospel must first be preached. Everybody shout with me. The gospel must first be preached. Not your business first. Not your family first. Listen, Matthew 6:33, the gospel first. Everybody, listen carefully. Any Christian that understands this and enter into the reality of it and enter into a financial covenant with God, that day, poverty comes to an end. And you now go into metamorphorical stages in it. I see a lot of believers, they are broke. How will the gospel first be preached to all nations? Zechariah chapter 1 verse 17. My cities, true prosperity, shall yet be spread abroad. This is the anchor. Everybody hear me. How will the gospel first be preached? How? Somebody shout with me, how? Zechariah 1:17 answers it. Vision gives you direction. Money gives you motion. When it gives you motion. Even the gospel will only be preached by empowerment. Ah! A poor church is an humiliated church. A broke church is a humiliated church. A broke believer is a humiliated believer. Ebrokatia aga andrishia deboria satalash. My cities, true prosperity, shall yet be spread abroad. God's cities. If you will covenant with God to enter into the eternal covenant of spreading the gospel first. I want somebody to scream with me quickly. Say first. Louder and louder, please.
Yes.
Louder and louder, please.
Yes.
Because that is the agenda of God on planet Earth. No devil, no economy, no situation, no condition can stop your financial progress. Against all odds, the work of your hand will prosper. You become a problem solver. The floodgate of ideas will open. Devourers will be rebuked. The blessings of the Lord will be poured forth. There will be supernatural abundance that no economy, no situation, no power can handle. And I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about. My cities, true prosperity, shall yet be spread abroad. My cities. Earlier this year, it's the will of God. We started our TV station, Masters TV. That's about $10,000 alone every month. This early year, we started 10 branches. Paying rent. You see, it is the agenda of God on planet Earth. The first crusade, God helped us as a church that we organized was Ugeli Stadium. Filled to capacity. And we spent $51 million, 2018. To win souls, $51 million. From there, we moved to Benin Crusade. Benin Crusade, we spent $41 million. My cities, true prosperity, shall yet be spread abroad. We spend millions to pay rent now, while we are still building. While we are still building. If an army of believers will rise up, to covenant with God. I'm going somewhere. Just follow me. And I will close by leading you in the covenant of 1 year. See what God will do, sir. Your heaven will burst open. There are a lot of pastors with the anointing for crusade. The vision is there. The money is not there. In crusade and in ministry, there is what prayer we do. There is what money we do. Anything money we do, prayer can do. Money is a weapon. Listen, what are you telling me? You don't know the battle we are in? We are reading it in the Bible, me and you. Holy Spirit interpreting it by revelation. The soldiers that were there, they saw Jesus rose. They saw angels roll away the stones. There was earthquake. Thunders, the heaven shook. They saw Isaiah, they saw Jeremiah, they saw the dead. All of them rose and went into the city. Manifestation of the power of resurrection. The Bible says they were given large sum of money to say that they slept off. And his disciples came and then they stole his body away. And the story is like that in Israel till date. The post-resurrection battle will be fought with money. If people that saw Christ rose were given money and they changed their mind, there are some battles now money for money. We are in an economic war. There are more than 25 million pornographic sites flowing free. And people are working and paying with their life. God didn't save you for you. It's so that the gospel must be preached first. Let me say it to you. You are not making money force for your comfort. You are not making money force for your family. You are not even supposed to build a house if there is a need in God's house. Many don't know why God can't bless them. I mean the blessing of the Lord. I mean the blessing of the Lord. Listen, God will take care of you more than you can take care of yourself. God will help you more than you are ready to help yourself. God will support you more than you are ready to support yourself. His cities, true prosperity, shall yet spread abroad. His cities, the spread of the kingdom. The spread of the kingdom. Yeah. Very soon, we'll plan to go on DSTV. It's money. It's not just prayer. We pray. But when we contacted DSTV, it's not much. It's just some thousands of dollars, up to maybe 200,000 USD. When you look, there are some things. You know, money answered at all things. There are some things when you call, it's money that must answer. How many Christian TVs are there? Maybe like Koza and some other ones or so. Look, there are some things you are just wasting your time. Pray all your prayers. When it is time for it, we don't pay rent with tongues. Look, diesel is running now. AC is blowing. Generator is running. If the generator stop working now, and then diesel is not there, we don't go there as pastors to be talking in tongues. Kakuka, prakatiada. Generator start working. Generator start working. They don't use money in heaven. It is needed here. I will lead you in a covenant tonight, sir. Myself and Lack totally divorced. The past 3 years, I've given over 183 cars. The past 3 years, I've given over 183 cars. And name the car that is not there. Name the car that is not there. Name that car that is not there. I've given S-Class. I've given G450. I've given, you know, under code 2019. Look, all kinds. Material things, they are nil to me. I mean, completely nil. Lift up your right hand. La broko shia. E di atsia da ambrike tia dish. Leke sia abrakasa. Can God trust you with a billion? Can God channel resources through you? Sir, look at me. Lift up your right hand. I'm going somewhere. A lot of us are struggling. A lot of us are trying to make ends meet. A lot of believers are running here, helter and skelter. It's the blessing of the Lord that maketh rich and had no sorrow. Lift up your right hand properly. Receive grace to practice kingdom economy. Receive it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Kingdom economy. Early this year, they called me from Enugu and gave me a massive landed property. Earlier this year, they called me from Lagos here, the director of one of the leading property estate business in Nigeria, drove down, located me, and handed over a property in Lekki to me. I have not checked it. I didn't check the two. I've given it out. I didn't check the two. The one in Enugu, the one in Via, I've given the two out. I've given it two out. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? For the gospel to be preached is the purpose of my life, sir. I will give you some 2-3 scriptures now. The economy of this kingdom rests absolutely on Galatians 6:7. God can't be mocked. Whatever a man soweth, he will reap. So therefore, listen to me. In this kingdom, God won't bless you more than your capacity to sow. Sowing is the capital key to kingdom economy. By faith. You can give me also 2 Corinthians from verse 9. The economy of this kingdom. 2 Corinthians chapter 9 from verse 6 quickly. You see it there also. But this I say, when you sow sparingly, you will reap sparingly. And when you sow bountifully, you will what? Yeah. So you see, You determine your place. God doesn't determine your blessing, you do. It's your the size of your seed that determines the size of your harvest. Pradeshi, sir, master giving, you have mastered life. Master giving, you have mastered life. Pro kati garashos. Leandre sia agambri katia dakas. A giver can be stranded. Now hear me, God's precious people. Starting with tithe. Giving is spiritual. It's more than you think. Giving is spiritual. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 8. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 8. Everybody follow me as I read this. Here, men that die receive the tithe. But there, he received them, of whom it is written that he lives forever. May I ask you quickly, who is he that liveth forever? I can't feel you. Is he that liveth forever? I can't feel you. Is he that liveth forever? I still can't hear you. Who is he that liveth forever? Here, men that die receive the tithe. So when you drop it, men that die, that will soon be translated to glory later, they receive it. But there, he receives it. Giving is a spiritual transaction that reflects your trust in God. Giving is more than you think. And we can quickly look at this, and then I give you some dynamics tonight. May the next 1 year open you up to a world of supernatural wonders. For the first time, you will not beg. You will not borrow. For the first time, you will know the meaning of a blessed life. Now, from the beginning, hear this. Cain and Abel gave on earth. It was on earth they gave, and it answered in heaven. Giving is spiritual. Now, listen again. That's, you know, Genesis 6. Now, Genesis 4, Genesis 6. By the same, Noah in Genesis 9, Noah gave on earth. It answered in heaven. You see, Genesis 8:22. Noah reared an altar and sacrificed. Hear me. Noah gave on earth. Heaven responded. That's why he said in Psalm 20, the Lord hear you in the day of trouble. The name God of Jacob defend you. Send you help from the sanctuary. Strengthen you from Zion. Above all, remember your offerings. And you are telling me that giving is normal. A non-giving Christian must suffer financially. It is not just giving, consistent giving. A Christian that can't give doesn't trust. This is where the power of sacrifice comes in. I don't want you to struggle. I don't want you to struggle. I repeat, I don't want you to struggle at all. Somebody shout with me, say, struggling has come to an end in my life. Louder and louder. Solomon gave on the earth. It answered in heaven. And God came down. 1 Kings chapter 3. David gave on earth. It answered in heaven. Mama Sibra and their Satalia Baroses. Pray on this sea. It's time for you to see the practical hand of God over your life. For God to break systems open. Sometimes I weep for days. What giving does? I have 9 benefits of giving, but I won't go to them. I will just summarize, then I give you some types of giving and how to grow in them. And then you are basking in eternal blessings. There are times I weep for days. I weep for days. And that Lord, how did this happen? How did I get to this point? I said to somebody, you will weep for days. I mean for joy. It will be joy. But you know, you can't laugh when it's too overwhelming. Let me say it again to you. I can testify.
Multitude can testify, God is too faithful, sir. This economy, I'm telling you, doesn't fail. Nobody can convince me otherwise. No sickness can move near my territory. I am the pandemic. I am a pandemic myself. What are all these things your people are talking about? What's corona? What are you telling me? I am a pandemic. I'm the pandemic. I will buffet you. Kilometers from where I live, no virus can move there. What are you people talking about now? Check it. The forces in Zion, the spirit of just men made perfect, the blood of sprinkling, God, the judge of all. Those are the forces in Zion. I check, no virus. So therefore, it can't spread in church, except that church is not the church of the living God. So don't shock yourself by covering your nose to death under ESC. Don't kill yourself. And don't last your mind. Don't kill yourself. Forget all those fear. Forget all those fear. You mean in Zion, there will something? No, it can't happen, sir. Sir, it can't happen, sir. Don't throw all those things away, sir. Jesus said, when I return, will I meet faith? Jesus said, when I return back to the earth, will I meet faith? By the breath of his nostrils, he will slay the wicked. That I am breathing, all armed robbers are under arrest. All occultic forces are under arrest. All demonic powers are under arrest. All satanic assault are under arrest. If I set on the road, all robbery activity, headsmen, I am the original one. I will shatter you. Now, what did you say? Wake up, oh. This is kingdom life. Wake up. And above all, you know the reason I can talk like this? I have God and I have some money. Abba. I have God. Economic empowerment is critical. Yeah. So that the church is not pushed aside. I say to you again, economic empowerment is critical. Now, quickly take this and let me help you. And now I'm going to the critical apostolic sessions. Then I will go into multifaceted dimensions of operation. The yoke of poverty over your life shall be broken tonight. I said the yoke of poverty over your destiny shall be broken right now. I say for the last time, the yoke of poverty over your life shall be broken right now. Quickly, say after me in the mighty name of Jesus and by the power of the Holy Spirit. Poverty, I break your power over my life. Say it again, poverty. I break your power over my life. 1 Kings chapter 3. 1 Kings chapter 3, beginning from verse 3. Now hear this. Solomon loved the Lord. 3 to 13, he went to Gibeon. He sacrificed there. And there, God appeared. Everybody hear me. In prayer, you ask God to visit you. In giving, God asks you. Therefore, may I help you? Giving is powerful than prayer. If you pray on anything and give on it, you have double-edged sword. Solomon did not ask God to visit him. You know, we are talking about revival. Sir, you want a revived life, be a giver. You will constantly be enjoying divine presence. I wake up in the morning, I see angels. Divine presence. Sometimes I see Catherine Kuma. I see spirit of just men all around me. Sometimes I'm in an aeroplane that is taking off. It will open my eyes. I see beings around me. There is no day I don't sacrifice. We are presently on 90-day sacrifice. I give sacrifice every day to the kingdom. Apart from to the poor, to the this, I give sacrifice every day. Everybody hear me. Do you enjoy these things? God came to Solomon. And God said to Solomon, ask me what I shall do. In prayer, you are asking God. In giving, God is asking you, choose your choice. Any Christian you see that is always praying to, look, we pray. Our church, we do night vigil every day. Look at me, may I help you? It's part of money. Like civil service, I have people employed. Level 16, level 14, level 13, prayer warriors on payroll. That the only job they do is to be praying. And we are paying. That's what money is meant for. That's what money is meant for. Look at your neighbor again and ask your neighbor. Say, neighbor, can you sow your seed here? And we pay some warriors to pray. Totally sold out to the kingdom. Let me say it to you again. Hey, listen. God came to Solomon and said to Solomon, ask me what I shall give thee. And everybody listening, Solomon said, give me wisdom. God said, I will give you and I've given you. But above all, read verse 13. He said, including what you didn't ask. You didn't ask for wealth, but nobody give and don't receive wealth. I have given you wisdom. Now listen, God said, I have also given thee that which thou hast not asked. Giving is the master key to unsolicited help, unsolicited blessing, unsolicited favor, unsolicited assistance. Please listen. If you are somebody that all your life you ask, you don't receive unsolicited help, unsolicited blessing, they've not opened the airport in Warri. We travel to Benin, even though I have powerful mopo, I have escort, I have security, I have all those things by His grace. But going back and forth, and I've been walking, so I was almost saying, I won't come for this meeting. That look, driving again to Benin, that look, I just need to rest. Then one of my sons sent a private jet, said, sir, this is for you, and that's 7 million naira. So I was joking with Pastor Abraham. I said, please tell Pastor Lumide, I don't want honorarium. They should just pay for the jet for me. I said, they should please just pay for the jet for me. To throw this trip that I came, it's 7 million naira. And I came with a private jet. I came with a private jet. It's so dignifying. It's so sweet. You know, it's good. It's a good life. Look at me. That is what giving does. If I see all your prayers now and it's just God, give me bread, God, give me butter, God, you are missing it in sowing to the kingdom. Those who attend to God first, God will attend to them first. You don't attend to God first and become last. Mark my words, sir. And it will have to be first in your finances. Look, from university, I've been paying 20% tithe. First semester, part three, I've been paying 20% tithe. NYSC, I began to pay 30-35% tithe. When I became a pastor, I was paying 40% tithe. I don't know the percentage I'm in now. In fact, it's over. It's all. We have given all and we have followed. Unsolicited help. Then listen again. In Genesis chapter 8, Noah sacrificed. And what happened? God said, I will no longer curse the earth. Listen. God vowed that he will no longer curse the earth. Anyone fighting a curse, a seed is what you need to terminate that siege. All these arrows from my father's house, arrows from my mother's house, there is no negative dream that has ever come to pass in my life. And I think I've had plenty of them. No negative prophecy has ever affected me. There is nobody that will say they saw this. It has never happened to me. Because I sowed my seed dangerously, sir. Listen to this. Because my senior brother also prayed with us. My wife, Pastor Esther Komaya, just did her 50th, April 5th. Yeah. And then, like 3 weeks or 4 weeks to her 50th birthday, looking very healthy, she just went to collect supplements for her aged mom. And then they said they just brought all this equipment and all those things to test. And then they put it on her body, and the result was devastating. It was a deadly death sentence. I operate healing grace, I do healing school, I do all those things. It was almost that she would not even be alive to see her 50th birthday. They said this sickness, 0% of people survive it. And it's over. And it's over. No. I will never enter a battle without a seed. And that is what I will talk on now before I close. Prasi braka shiadaka. Immediately. I called my son in America. I sent a seed to Gloria Copeland. Then I raised a massive seed to Mommy Faith Oyedepo. Then I sent another seed to Pastor David Ibiome. The rest is story. They took another blood sample and sent it to South Africa and America. The result came back. It has vanished. Completely vanished. Not a trace. Look, clear bill of health. And that is the highest form of giving. Philippians chapter 4, 15 to 19. Sowing to the anointed. I will share personal stories and then I go into ministration. Where is the anointing? Because the kingdom of God operates on principles. The anointing is on the anointed. The anointing is in the anointed. The anointing is with the anointed. Mama Sibra Atolia Chakara. Believe in the Lord your God you are established. These are kingdom dynamics. Believe in this prophet, so shall you prosper. I know the grace of God upon God's general here, Pastor Lumide Emmanuel, speaking over you. How can you know if all the prophecies of God's servant has come to pass in your life, by now you won't be this size? What is making it not to come to pass? It's what I want to close with now. He said, ye Philippians know, no church communicated with me concerning giving and receiving except you. When I was in Macedonia, you sent once and again to my necessity. Not that I desire anything from you, but that it may be accredited to your account. In conclusion, for sowing to the life of the anointed, he said, I have received what you sent. Good smelling. You gave it to the prophet, but heaven smelled it. You gave it to the prophet, heaven received it. If the widow of Zarephath ate it, it's true, she would die. If a prophet eats it, she will live. There is a money, if you spend it, it won't go well. But if your pastor spends it, all will go well. It's the law of the spirit. Social media can say whatever they want to say. You are not saved by social media. You're not saved by social media. They can be saying whatever they want to say. Be guided by revelation. Two August ago, I had one S-Class, Mercedes-Benz S500. I strongly believe that if there are cars in heaven, S-Class will be one. If you use S-Class, you may not want to use any car again. I mean S500. And then God said, give it to Pastor David Ibiome. I gave it to Pastor David Ibiome. 2018, we did covenant of 12 cars. With Pastor David Ibiome. Every month, we are giving Pastor David Ibiome one luxury car. Every month. Every month of 2018, one luxury car was given. One luxury car I will give him. One luxury car. One luxury car I will give. One luxury car I will give. One luxury car. Sir, everything moved to another level, sir. Then in 3 months, they blessed me with another S-Class. Better than the previous one. About 35 million naira. Then, two Decembers ago, not this last December, the one before that one. Then, we came to Kilanandia for Shiloh, and then we finished. I got back to what God said, give your father, Bishop Oyedepo, this S-Class. To the glory of God, the convention in Kilanandia 48 last week, Thursday of it, he still drove that car. I look at it, I said, this is my seed. Say, this is my seed speaking for me. Ambisia abriandia satalia barashas. Is the grace you sow into that answers. I thank God that tomorrow is his birthday. But sir, why so on the birthday? Something that should be daily. You make it once a year. They don't say happy birthday, sir. They don't say, sir, I enjoyed the message. You don't understand. You don't understand. I replicate grace, sir. So I took that S class. I sent it to Bishop David Oyedepo. He called me. You know, listen to me. There are prayers. It's venison that can bring it out. Look, let me tell you. People think we are carnal, but let me tell you the truth. Even God, holy God, said he loves a cheerful giver. So I should hate them. God said he loves a cheerful giver. So me, because I'm pastor, because I don't discriminate, because I should hate them. Who hates giver? Not even Jehovah. You can't be a giver. Everyone will smile at you. Earth will smile. Your destiny will be soft. The ground will be softened for you, sir. My father, Bishop Oyedepo, there is nothing I give Pastor Ebiyome or Bishop Oyedepo that they need. They are so blessed. Follow me, I'm closing. Lucky, sir, and I want to usher you into a covenant, sir. It's time for you to touch things. Then Bishop Oyedepo called me and said, son, I'm the one you bless with this car. Enter into the realm I operate. Look, there are prayers that are enchantments. I mean scriptural concocted enchantment. I'm sorry, if you watch in those days, Ogunde films, white witches and black witches, the white witches and the black witches will be fighting. They will be using incantations against each other. When Ogunde, the king of the white witches, comes out, Ashe. So there are apostles with Ashe. I don't know how to say it in English, but Ashe. Tell your neighbor Ashe. You will see the white witches and the white witches and the black witches fighting. Sometimes the black witches will want to win. Sometimes the white witches will want to win. But when Ogunde just come out like this, one by one, the wind will just come, bam, 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 and clear them, and they will turn back. Asheni. Look, a grace you sow into, it will speak over your life, it will stick. It will stick. Bishop Oyedepo said to me, he said, enter into the realm. The ravens feeding me, Kumaya, now they feed you. He said, look, the honor I enjoy it. In 3 weeks, 3 billionaires came into my life. They sow in millions weekly. Sir, they bless me like mad. They give me, look, I'm telling you, they sow dangerously to my life. September, bought a car about 16 million. December again, I gave it this last December. And I love that car. Under Accord Sport 2019. 16 million naira. I like that car. I just like it. We finished the other. I sent it to Canaanland. And he spoke again to my life. Listen to me. From December last year, I obeyed God in giving recklessly to prophets. I can't go into testimony. Are you talking about Pastor Matthew Ashimolowo? I sold, sir. Pastor David Ibiome is constant. I gave, sir. To my helpline, I gave, sir. Even the work of my hand begins to prosper. Men greet me and give me. Sir, people give me and beg me to take. Landed property from the east, from the west, from the north, from the south. One day, February this year, somebody gave me 34 million and still begged me that daddy is small, but just take it. I was happy, but I do as if it's small too. I said, okay. Well,
God bless you. You try next time. You try next time. You, God bless you. You try.
There are realms. Rise up on your feet. Look at your neighbor now and tell your neighbor, say, there are realms. I can't hear you. I said, tell your neighbor, there are realms. Say it to another neighbor, say, there are realms. I want you to see, say it to another neighbor now, say, there are realms. Shout it to your neighbor, say, there are realms. Scream it for the last time. Say, I say, there are realms. Let me help you. Sowing to Pastor Lumide's life is more important than sowing to Calvary. I repeat, sowing to the life of the prophet is superior to sowing into the ministry of the prophet. That grace is not on salvation. The grace for salvation in salvation ministries is not in salvation, it's on the Biome. That grace is not upon winners, it's upon David Oyedepo. That grace of God upon Calvary is not upon Calvary, it's upon the vessel. That is why if the grace of God upon Church of God Mission was upon Church of God Mission, not upon Archbishop, when Archbishop left, it should just continue. It is vessels that carry grace, not ministry. At this point, I want to operate apostolically. And because my focus is finance tonight, it won't take God anything to make you a billionaire. Can you be trusted with money? Will you be faithful with money? Will you be faithful with money? Can you be trusted with money? After these things, God did test Abraham. God did test Abraham. Mandibu sia ebrosia angitali brekitia dakaros. Lea this sia, are you sick in your body? A seed contaminate it. Do you want devourers to be rebuked? Rain of ideas? You want to become a problem solver? Giving can grant you access to it. You want to enter into new dimensions? I don't know the meaning of stagnation. We do membership school in the church every day. People join our church on a daily basis, including Sunday. We do membership school, including Sunday, sir. We it's Sunday to Sunday we do membership school. People join us weekly. Hear me, the few minutes we have. How long will you be on the floor? How long will you be pushing it? Your location is not your problem. Your connection is it in the covenant. Tithe is elementary. By now, some of us, you are supposed not to be at the realm of tithing at all. What is tithe? Super elementary doctrine, pre-nursery. He that goeth forth weeping, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again rejoicing. Look at me, carrying his sheaves with him. This is kingdom economy. You are not to suffer what they suffer. You are not to suffer what they suffer. You are not to be broke as they are broke. You are not to beg as they beg. You can live in super abundance. I repeat, you can live in super abundance. I repeat, you can live in super abundance. I told some of our team this morning, I flew in, they brought me with a private jet yesterday, and I was lodged at the hotel. How many properties have I been called, has been given to me and the ministry in 24 hours? With pictures. Oh, this has been given. We've gone to check it. Oh, that has been given. We've gone to check it. Oh, excuse me, sir. We have gone to check this one again. It's been given. We've gone to check that one. I said, okay, sell them and let them be used for the project. And this year, Abrakatia Dakara. People sow like this into the life of the anointed. Things turn around. It's time to embrace this kingdom lifestyle. Let me make it clear before I close. No Christian can be blessed by God financially more than the giving lifestyle of that Christian. It is impossible. And no matter the tithe, the sacrifice, if you don't sow into the life of the anointed, something will be missing. I give it over every day. Every day. There are times 5 million from my pocket to my prophet. Yes, 3 million, 1.5 million, virtually every week. As church is doing, my family is doing. Myself. As church is doing, I am doing. I have said it and I will say it again. I will never use a car better than the one my pastor uses. If I'm a church, it will never happen to me. Never. I say never. I don't give them things because it's their birthday. I have the revelation. Hebrews 7:7, without any contradiction, the less is blessed of the better. Handebosia abrakosia dakaras. Lekosia brakasa. For about 3-4 times, Pastor Biome has prayed some prayers for me and has spoken some definite things into my life. He said, bring me a venison. It's the divine order. It's the divine order. Nobody is buying miracle. Don't misconstrue us. But because money has capacity to be worshipped, God has created a system that it must flow through you so that you don't start worshipping it. Anything you can give, you are now worshipping. It has now become an idol. It has now become an idol. I can't go into other blessings, generational blessings, favor on every side. If you are perpetually broke, check your giving life. If you don't enjoy help, check your giving life. If you are moving from battle to battle, check your giving life. If the work of your hand is not prospering, irrespective of the economy, check your giving life. With all humility, I was almost praying that pandemic should not end. Sir, I saw things. So, sir, with all humility, I called bank more than 3 times to help me check that they should trace these account numbers, transferring money. Are they angels or normal human beings? An average of 5 million naira daily throughout the pandemic. And immediately the pandemic stopped. It stopped. I said, God, let this thing continue. Sir, look at me. You must ask people for things they don't give you. You knock, knock, knock. Door is not opening. You don't carry divine presence. I don't like ideas for my work. You lack ideas for your work. You are struggling at the same spot. You don't receive unsolicited help. People don't extend hand to help you. No. Check it. Things are, you are just in a tight corner. Now, I want to speak as a prophet now. Every one of you in a financial tight corner, I command you be out right now. I command you be out right now. Lift up your 2 hands. Asi brakasha. Edu satia des. Le edu sia abrakatia dakaush. Lindo sia brakat. I will lead you in a covenant. I've never called this kind of sacrifice. If not that I'm a part of this house, I will not go into it. It's 12 months, sir. Sir, nobody, no prayer can help. Change church, except you want to go and be doing magic. Giving is critical to the heart of God. After these things, God tested Abraham. Look at me. Genesis 22, God said to Abraham, bring Isaac, whom you love. If I ask you now, can I do 2 examinations? Can I have 2 people? Young man, can you come? Lady, please, can you come? This lady inquire here. Please, can you come? God said, Abraham, give me Isaac. And God said, whom you love. If God said to Abraham, give me Ishmael, Abraham can ask God, should I hurt the mom? Listen, God said to Abraham, give me Isaac, whom you love. Materially speaking, what is the material thing you love most on earth now? It can be your gold, it can be your car if you have. What is the material thing you love most? It can be a savings, it can be your salary. What is the material thing you love most?
Investment, my savings.
your savings. Go back. Go and bring all the investments. Go back. Is that what you love?
Materially, yes.
That's the material thing you love. You don't need to hear God and be prophet. He has already sent me to tell you. You know, people say, I want to be hearing God. I want to be hearing God. I want to be hearing God. Because the sacrifice I'm calling tonight, give God what you love, and God will show you. Give God. Okay, as you are listening to me now, everybody, ask your neighbor, what do you love most? Some of you now, you will now change it that it's no longer your car, it's your stove in the kitchen. Yes, you see, human being? You see, human being? Instead of saying your car, some of you will now say, it's actually our cooking gas. Ask your neighbor again, say, what do you love most? Let me ask my sister, what is the material thing you love most? Look at me. Dear God, and you will not regret. He is too faithful, sir. He is too faithful. He will not disappoint, sir. Except you don't believe. Wrap your faith. Giving is not economical, it's spiritual. Please, it's not an economic decision. My sister, what material thing do you love most? It can be your bag, it can be something. What is it?
No, my job.
Your what?
My work.
Your work. And so what does it earn you? Yeah, because I must quantify it. They just don't love job. It is what the thing is bringing and that makes them to love it. Very good. So whatever monthly comes in, don't touch it, bring it. Who therefore is ready tonight to plug into kingdom economy and the entrance into Abrahamic generational blessings? Look at me. God that said we should not vow, God vowed on Abraham. God said, I am Jehovah. I have said human beings should not vow. But Abraham, alone, I vow to you, Abraham. I swear to you, Abraham, because you have done this thing, you have given me what you love most. That means you love me now more than anyone. Abraham, in blessing, I will bless you. Abraham, your seed will possess the gate of their enemies. I mean sworn blessings. A lot of people saying, Abraham, blessings are mine. No, it is giving God what you love. From the east to the west, to the north and to the south, I am a prophet and I carry a prophetic mandate. It's because of time I will have still been able to do some things. But from the east, the west, even those that are online, how many people tonight will join by faith to give God what they love? Rise up. Stand up. Thank God you are standing. Just move out. It's a simple sacrifice. The test has started. Is it your car? Is it your landed property? Is it your only house? Look at me. Let me help you. One of the billionaires in Nigeria today, he just finished his house about 18 years ago. He moved into the house. He's building a $1 billion estate in Ikoyi now. 18 years ago, he just finished his own house and moved in. And in the evening of that day, God said he should drive around the area. He now drove. He was just going. He now saw an orphanage. God said, enter. He entered into the orphanage, dilapidated. And God said, I move you to build this house in this area so that this orphanage can move there. Move back to a rented apartment. Let the orphanage move in. He placed all the pastors in his church on salary. This person I'm saying. It's a billionaire to the core. These things don't just happen. It will keep testing you. There is no need for anybody to be praying, to be, sir, give and see what will happen. So therefore, all eyes closed. Angels are moving all over this place. Next generation millionaires and billionaires have been touched. I want to make it clear. This seed of what you love is not to Calvary, is to the life of Pastor Lumide. I will do a ministration tonight. If it is not confirmed, then I'm not a prophet. then I'm not a prophet. Listen to me. I know the days then of wisdom for singles is a general in the body of Christ. It's a man I believe in. He has labored. Yes. From here, a fountain of grace is being unleashed over our entire generation. Over our entire generation. Thank God for a lot of churches. This is global. I don't want to be mentioning names. Since when has he been filling stadiums? Since when has he been filling stadiums? Yes. Yes. Recently, God told me during the pandemic, all pastors that are 65, 70 years, including Assemblies of God, First Choir Church, they've retired, sir. They are dying of hypertension. I have to place about 71 of them on salary. If I show you what I spend every month, it will marvel you. Some of them have retired. They are on salary now. They are on salary now. Myself and my family, we are paying. We are paying. I have a host of widows that their husband died in active service. They are on my scholarship too. Myself and my family, we are paying. Up till yesterday, a widow messaged me this morning and said, exactly 7 years ago, my husband, a pastor in the city of Warri, died. Then you stepped into our life and took over our expenses. You are the one that has made us not to regret life. Thank you, sir. Eye to the blind, leg to the lame. I can testify of this. I can testify of this. This seed I'm calling tonight, yeah, from the east, the west, the north, and the south, it's not just for his birthday, please. Thank God for the birthday. But it says it can be a car, it can be a house, it can be. So it's not to Truth of Calvary Ministries. It's not to Calvary. This is to the prophet. And I tell you, I will go into ministration now. You won't regret it. Because time is fast spent. Listen to me. The oil of grace is over this place. I know what I carry. I know what I carry, sir. The testimony that will shake the foundation of this place will take place. Quickly, from the east to the west, to the north and to the south, the sacrifice of giving what you love, you want to participate in it, quickly move outside now. Time is going. At the count of 10, 1, I'm waiting. I'm waiting. 2, I'm Rakashtala Bastuliai. 2, 3. 3. If you have ever believed God in your life, this is the time to believe God. If you have ever believed God in your life, this is the time to believe God. You have to stretch yourself. 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 You have to, yes, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4. Okay, 5, 5. Yes, move. Embrodosia Brakatish. Embrakosia Dakara. Embrodosia. I can point some of you. I can point some of you. Ma'am, please stand up and come. No, the woman beside you. Yeah, please come. Don't stay there. Don't stay there. An angel carrying a basket is about to pass you. An angel carrying a basket is about to pass you. I want you to release your faith. I want all ministers, all pastors in Calvary out. Not even wait to be called. If you are a pastor in Calvary, if you are a worker in Calvary, if you are a leader in Calvary, you can't be under a grace you don't believe in. Come out. Just can't be. It just can't work. It just can't work. Except you don't believe, you don't come out. Except you, please, if you don't believe, don't come out. Because he loves a cheerful giver that delights in his giving. That delights in his giving. That delights in his giving. I don't know what is wrong with one of your ears. It has just popped open. Your mother has partial stroke. Right now, check the time. Check the time. Your mother is healed right now. Your mother is healed right now. About 11 days ago, you had a dream. And it's like in that dream, you are shot. And ever since then, the fear of gunshot, robbery attack has come upon you. That arrow is back to sender, and that spirit of fear is cast out. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6. This is how I'm going to close tonight. 6, 6, 6, 6, 6. 7, 7, 7. 8, 8, 9. Yes, don't wait. Don't wait. Anyone believing God for the fruit of the womb, angels are distributing children. I don't know who you are. God said I should tell you that delay is over. That shame is over. Every one of you in front, quickly stretch forth your two hands. Stretch forth your two hands. You will remember this season. You will never forget it. It's the day your story is changing. The first night of this conference, 2021, I give you 1 minute before I close. Speak to the Lord. What do you desire? What do you desire? I say, what do you desire? I say, what do you desire? The heavens over you will open. Mercy will prevail over judgment. The power that raised Christ from the dead shall be made manifest. The glory of God will descend upon you. The power of his Christ will descend upon you. Yes, 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 yes. I give you 1 minute. We are closing. Emrakatia dakaradish, lebrondi salia dakaros, lindrosia deros. Emrakotia dakarish, librotia dakaria dakaras. I give you 1 minute. I give you 1 minute. I give you 1 minute. Nothing will remain the same again. Your destiny is moving to the next level. I'm saying to you that nothing. In fact, there will be 24 hours testimony. The supernatural will take over the natural. 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 This is the sacrifice of Isaac. This is the sacrifice of Isaac. This is the sacrifice of Isaac. We are not following cunningly devised fables. 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 I give you 30 seconds more. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everybody stretch forth your two hands. Everybody in the congregation. I see some people on the highest. I see places filled to the back. Amrokotia Dakarosh. Lebrandusia Dekes. Leprondusia Abrakata. Wherein I'm even seeing a lot of things, but I can't go into talking now because of time. At another time, we'll be able to do that, and other ministers. So I will just prophesy generally before I will now call God's servant, whose life and grace this seed is being sown into. Everyone in front, please help me. And everyone connected, you will see his account details will be shown. Multimedia, please help. Other details, yes. Please, you can contact the church office. There will be phone lines. Please, you can give email address. That in case people online, yes, yes. This is a global meeting. Every one of you in front, where you are, please off your shoes and stretch forth your two hands. Oh, earth, hear ye the word of the Lord. This is a covenant, sir. This is a covenant. I've shared your word. Prakosia this before I hand over the mic to God's servant. Every one of you, stretch forth your two hands. Embrakosia dakaria this. Lekusia abrakatia dakarus. Limbrokotia diandis. Likus imbroktia this. Lekondi sabri andia satolia brakas. Stretch forth your two hands. Ambrakosia dakas. Giving is the only thing in the Bible that meets all needs. He said, my God shall supply. The God of the prophet you sow into will meet all your need. Now stretch forth your two hands. I therefore decree within 24 hours. I say again, Philippians 4:19 becomes your experience. I say to you, all your needs are met. All your needs are met. All your needs are met. Your captivity is torn. That shame is over. That disgrace is over. That retrogression is over. That sickness is over. That ancestral curse is over. That limitation is over. That nightmare is over. That satanic assault is over. That demonic attack is over. That retrogression is over. That difficulty is over. Every one of you sowing the Isaac sacrifice tonight, instantly, you are out of tight corners. I say you are out of tight corners. Now listen to me. Unsolicited blessings will visit you. Unsolicited help will visit you. Unsolicited grace will visit you. When you call for one, 10 will answer. The hand of God rest upon you. The grace of God rest upon you. The mercy of God rest upon you. And the power of God rest upon you. Instantly now, I decree your captivity is torn. Right now, my God, move you to the next level. My God, move you to the next level. My God, move you to the next level. Finally, my God, move you to the next level. I decree generational open doors. I decree supernatural open doors. I decree debt cancellation. I decree blessings upon blessings, mercy upon mercy, grace upon grace, help upon help, favor upon favor. I say to you, you are out of that tight corner. You are out of that tight corner. Finally, you are out of that tight corner. By this time tomorrow, there are testimonies already. The wind of favor blows on you. The wind of grace blows on you. The wind of mercy blows on you. The wind of progress blows on you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, stretch forth those two hands. Ebrotia da kariadish, lendrokotia da kas, lembrakotishis. Everybody listening, this is a most crucial moment. Even all the people in the assembly, you can't allow tonight to go and you don't enter into kingdom economy. A life of giving. 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 God is taking over that battle. God is taking over that battle. That battle you have been fighting for long, God is taking it over. God is taking over that battle. I know this as I know my name. God is taking over your battles. God is taking over your battle. One more minute quickly. God is taking over your battles. 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 God is taking over your challenges. God is taking over your battles. God is taking over your challenges. You are closer than you think. It will no longer be delayed. I don't know who you are. Every time you are almost touching it, then they take it further. Every time you are almost touching it, they take it further. Mark my word, for the first time in 7 days, you will touch it. I hear clearly, everyone that stepped out, the spirit of delay over your life is destroyed. Instantly, you have any sickness in any part of your body, place your hand there. There will be instant healing now. I know it as I know my name. Place your hand there. No matter the name of the sickness, check it. Instantly now, receive your healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive your healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive your healing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That brother in white shirt and black suit, just place your hand on your chest. Yes, yes, yes. Place your hand on your chest. I'm talking to you. You should just look at me. Place your hand on your chest. Place your hand on your chest. Just see the Spirit of the Lord. If you will be faithful with the covenant, I'm seeing into 15, 16 years' time. Yes, 15, 16 years' time. I'm seeing you flying in private jet. I'm seeing you in conferences and doing meetings with white people. I'm seeing you in international journeys and contracts. If you will be faithful to the covenant, if you will be faithful to the covenant, if you will be faithful to the covenant, God said, I should tell you specifically, you are one of the reasons why he organized this conference. Yes, yes, yes. There is expectation on you. Your family is looking in your direction. Multitude are looking in your direction. Multitude are looking in your direction. The hope in your direction is much. Is almost placing a burden on you. It's almost placing a massive burden on you. It's placing a massive burden on you. And you are struggling. You are stretching. But don't say the Spirit of the Lord, the power that raised Christ from the dead. Tonight, you are out of tight corner. lift him up as I breathe on you the breath of life. No, let him just stay like that. Lift up your head, young man. Rakosia agratasta. You are crying. There is a curse that entered into your lineage from actually your father's side. That is limiting men from rising. This hour, that curse is broken.
Amen.
That snare is shattered.
Amen.
Start from little or nothing you have now. It's your turn to make a change. Say the Spirit of the Lord. Erosi ebro entolia brakatia dakaras. Leprodosikitish leprokotia abrakatia dakaras. You take with one hand, you throw away with the other. You take with one hand, you throw away with the other. It's like this, your hands now, young man, as I'm looking, is filled with holes. It's filled with holes and it's leaking. It's leaking. It's like blessings doesn't stay, favor doesn't stay, mercy doesn't stay, help does not stay at all in your hand there. And it's non-alignment to the covenant. Yes, yes, non-alignment to the covenant. Thus says the Lord, as you align yourself to the covenant, in the name of Jesus Christ, I block those holes.
Amen.
I block those holes.
Amen.
I block those holes.
Amen.
Now an idea will be given to you between now and the next 4 days. It will be a massive idea that will shift your destiny. Now it will give you fear because you will be thinking of how will this be done. Something similar to it has been given to you 2-3 years ago and it slipped off because of the capital involved. Listen carefully, I'm speaking as a prophet. As you align into this covenant, a helper, somebody will come into your life 11 days after today. Yes, mark it, 11 days after today. Now in 4 days time you will receive an idea. 11 days after this day, an helper that will support that dream will come into your life, and that helper will lead you to another helper, and two of them will stand by you. Say the Spirit of the Lord. Ambrotiga, everybody lift up your 2 hands. Before Brakatiga Tish, Lendro Kitia, Abra Atia Dakaria Dakaros, Lembro Andia Sua, Abrokotia Dekeres, Likotia di Atia Dakaros, Likusia, Abro Andi Atia Dakas. There is an angel to my right talking to me. Ambro Andia Siadish, Lia, Ekusabrikitia Dakaros, Embrokatia Dis. Le ekostia bra andia sotolish lik indrosia abrakatia dakaria dakaras le cro etoli brakatia dekes. I hear clearly change of strategy, sir. Change of strategy. Change of strategy. I hear clearly change of strategy. Yes, 2 seasons have been missed because of applying old strategy in new dimensions. So change of strategy. God said I should tell you to spend the next 7 days after sacrifice to ask for wisdom. By this, receive the spirit of wisdom. There is a massive greatness ahead of you, but wisdom is required. The wisdom I'm talking about is like the wisdom of the gods. It's like the wisdom of the gods. It's like the wisdom of the gods. Say the Spirit of the Lord. Leprakotikachis, Lendropotiade, Etroposiades, Liandrishali, Etropotiada, Lekotalia, Adiasia Dakaris, Lik Indropre, Etolia Brakashia Dakara. Your name will become alias wise. People will wonder what kind of wisdom is this. Welcome to the wisdom era. Yes, you will come up with strategies. You will come up with strategies that will change paradigms. Yes, you will become somebody to copy. They will be calling you to deliver notes and lectures as you will be talking about strategy development. Say it, the Spirit of the Lord. Everybody stretch forth your 2 hands. Ebru andia satalia brakatosh, likus indropre etolia brakatas. Lekotia drakatia dakares, likus indro eprokotia dakarash, leprakosia dakaria disti. There is a key that's just been delivered into your hands. There is a key. there is a key. There is a door that you have never ever been able to open. It's a wave of new level. I hear clearly a wave of new level. A wave of new level. Ekus imbro atia agashatalia daga. Does hear the Spirit of the Lord? A new chapter has just been opened unto you. A new chapter has just been opened unto you. Immediately after this sacrifice, God is going to give you three other instructions. Be very sensitive in the spirit. Three other instructions will be given to you, and they will be heart shaking. But believe me, sir, your life and destiny will never ever remain the same again. Say it, the Spirit of the Lord. One or two more. Can they help me get microphone for Pastor Lumide, please? Please, sir, this is what I'm told. You will speak in tongues, I will interpret. You will speak in tongues, I will interpret, and then I will hand over the mic. There is a word he has given you. You will say it in the spirit. I will say it in understanding. You will speak in tongues. Everybody now, this environment is prophetic. No sickness can survive. No curse can survive. No attack of hell can survive. I don't know who you are. The most wicked woman in your family, afflicting the family, is now dead. This testimony will happen between now and this time tomorrow. The most wicked person in your family, destroying the family, is dead. Listen, this is our last night. This is their last night. Say it, the Spirit of the Lord. Ebro Kotia, time is gone. But Lord, help me, help me. Ebro Katia Kwashia Dakarut. Lendro Kotika Tutis. Le Krondisia Akatia Shatalas. Edro Andri se Eprakotia Dakas. Ike Idroshia, is she the one? Drakotiki Impropretolis. Lea Androshia Aprakatia Dakas. I wanted to talk to you, but you are crying to God. Leave him on. You are crying to God that I should not bypass you. I'm supposed to talk to her, but you cry to God that, Lord, 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 I am at a crossroad. I am at a crossroad. Let him talk to me. Let him talk to me. Now, pre and DC, Abro Atiakushia Dakaria De. You are saying yes, sir. Kika Sia Abra Taligaras. Ayera Yeo pre Endebosia Dakaria De. If you procure that force sitting on your destiny, that power pressing down your glory, is hereby destroyed by fire. Ebro kotikisia agatia dakaras. Ebro kotia, I hear clearly, break ancestral power over him. Break ancestral power over him. Now, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I break ancestral bondage over your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I hear clearly you have an international destiny. You have an international destiny. You can't die locally. I therefore release your destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus. Risa Abra. There is a change of garment. There is a change of garment. Your clothes have been changed. Listen, your wardrobe is being changed. Your shame is being wiped. Yes, there is a change of garment. There is a change of story. I hear clearly the garment of shame is removed. The garment of beauty is released. Say it, the Spirit of the Lord. Everybody stretch forth your hands. I need to do this with God's general, then I hand over the mic. Please don't go. Don't go. Forget time. Oh. This is once a year. This is once a year. This is once a year. Now listen, everybody, stretch forth your hands. Blind eyes will open now. Lame will walk. The sick will be healed. No affliction will survive. Every bondage will be broken. Listen to me, there is debt cancellation. If you are owing money, you will see mercy, sir. If you are owing money, you will see mercy. By this sacrifice, you will see mercy. Stretch forth your two hands, everybody. Look in this direction. Whether you are out or not, don't leave this place without a sacrifice to the life of God's servant. To the life of God's servant. Please, and Philippians 4:16. not once in a while, not once and for all, once and again. Time will not permit me. It's a lifestyle. Join us for leadership class together tomorrow, ministers conference, whether you are a businessman or in ministry, and we will tell you the nitty-gritty of the entire story. As God's servant will be prophet, will speak in tongues, I will interpret. He will speak in tongues, I will interpret. Then he will take over. Nobody should leave tonight without dropping an Isaac seed, and swarm blessings will become your portion. Your second child is a stammerer, is healed right now. Your second child is a stammerer. Go and check him now. He will speak fluently. Go and check. If you have any growth on your body, check. It has disappeared. Any lump, any inflammation, any growth, check it. It has disappeared. Every spirit of sickness is cursed in the name of Jesus. Now stretch forth your two hands over to you, sir. I have come in my power to help you. I have come in my majesty to answer your prayers of yesteryears. I am eager to help you more than you are eager to receive my help, said the Lord. It is true you have made some mistakes. Forgive yourself, for I have forgiven you. I am God. Beside me, there is none else. When I open a door, no one can close it. When I close a door, no one can shut it. I have opened to you generational door of blessings.
I have procured ikato malingrudu shatahande here.
I have stretched forth my hand again like I cook for them in the wilderness. I have entered my kitchen and I am cooking again for my children. From today you shall gather on a daily basis. The work of your hand shall prosper. Every plan of the enemy against your family, I have thwarted. I have made your forehead 10 times stronger than the forehead of your enemy. Why do you believe in your enemies more than you believe in me? I have told you to believe me. I have told you to believe me. Believe me is the only thing I want you to do. I am God. Believe me. See, I have opened unto you a door no one can close. Enter. Don't be afraid. Don't look at the enemy. Enter into the blessing. Enter into the blessing.
Makapo takiande.
It is done. Lift up your two hands and give him praise.
Rejoice in the Lord tonight. 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 From glory to glory, from testimony to testimony. Return to your seats. Everybody lift up your hands to heaven and wave it to God and begin to give him thanks. Bye-bye to poverty. Bye-bye to lack. Bye-bye to hardship. Bye-bye to pain. Bye-bye to sorrow. Bye-bye to everything that is contrary to the covenant. Is that how to wave your hands? Wave it away, wave it away, wave it away. Wave your hands, wave your hands. Bye-bye to pain. Bye-bye to sorrow. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In the next 2 minutes, I want you to shout 7 times, thank you, Jesus. 1, 2, 3, go. From now to the end of the year, you will have reasons to say thank you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus. If you are blessed tonight, put your hands together, celebrate God, celebrate God.